Propagate, or you can say to propagate this belief that everything that exists is Allah. So when you see the Sufis, when they make zikr, when they say illallah, 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 this means in reality this means la mawjuda illallah. And this is practiced in all of their masajid. Don't be surprised. And there's a lot of these masajid that you will see some of these people, these that they make dhikr and they say illallah, illallah. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say that La ilaha illallah means La ma'buda haqqun illallah. And this was the explanation which was given by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, where he says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي فَإِنَّهُ سَيَهْدِينِ وَجَعَلَهَا كَلِمَةً بَاقِيَةً فِي أَقِبِهِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Where Ibrahim alayhi salam said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was addressed with regards to Ibrahim alayhi salam. And remember when Ibrahim said to his father and his people, indeed I am free of what you worship, except him. Meaning I worship none but Allah alone, who did create me, and verily he will guide me. And he made it, i.e. the statement, la ilaha illallah, a lasting word among his offspring, that they may turn back, i.e. repent to Allah or receive admonition. As Surah Zukhruf, ayah number from 26 to 28. So this is Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the meaning of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah has been derived from the statement of Ibrahim alayhi salam with regards to who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلَهَا كَلِمَةً بَاقِيَةً. That this statement, كَلِمَةً بَاقِيَةً, a statement that will be remembered, statement which is a lasting word, a statement that will be remembered amongst the offspring of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and will be remembered amongst the offspring of Ibrahim alayhi salam who will follow the footsteps of Ibrahim alayhi salam, will be la ilaha illallah, meaning la ma'buda haqqun illallah. And if you look at all the mufassireen from Al-Qurun Al-Mufaddala, in the golden era, every single one gave this tafsir of la ma'buda haqqun illallah. When the Sufis appeared after the golden era of Islam, this meaning of la mawjuda illallah came from them under the influence of the Hindus and the Buddhists and the pagans and those who came after him, the likes of Ibn Arabi, the Sufi, the Spaniard who came from Spain, who believed that in reality nothing exists other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with regards to what Shaykh al-Islam, Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad al-Wahhab rahimahullah mentioned, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, he mentioned with regards to the shahada, shahadati la ilaha illallah. And then he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned awa tuqim as-salah, to pray salah. And the establishment of the salah has been mentioned in the Quran and zakat together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions where he says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُ الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمِ. In Surah Al-Bayyinah, ayah number 5. And they were commanded not but that they should worship Allah and worship none but Him alone, abstain from ascribing partners to Him, and perform the salah and give zakat, and that is the right religion. So if you look here in this ayah, the first thing that you find when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Al-Bayyinah about the believers and in regards to those who He has commanded, the whole of mankind, as well as the believers, that you will find them that وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, that the believers were not commanded except to make ibadah of Allah mukhlisi, sincerely to Him alone. So again in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first started with Tawheed. He mentioned that they were mukhlis. He mentioned that if they are mukhlis, if they are sincere, if they are upon Tawheed, this is what they have been commanded. Then they were commanded to pray, and then they were commanded to give a zakah. So again in the Quran we find the same order, that Allah starts with Tawheed, that when the people are firm upon Tawheed, then they are to pray, and then they are to give zakah. So somebody asks us, what is the evidence That the first thing is that we call to Tawheed, then we call to prayer, and then we call to giving zakah, and then we call to fasting, and then we call to Al-Hajj, meaning all the pillars that come after that. We say that the evidence for this is Surah Al-Bayyinah, ayah number 5. That in Surah Al-Bayyinah, ayah number 5, first talks about Tawheed, then it talks about prayer and zakah. So this is exact. So the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in accordance to Surah Al-Bayyinah. Now, and with regards to fasting, then the ayah Shahr Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran where he says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum usiyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqoon. O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed for you as just as it was prescribed for those who before you. And with regards to the Hajj, like I mentioned, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ هِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ إِسْتَطَاهَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. And Hajj pilgrimage to Mecca, to the house of Kaaba, is a duty that mankind owes to Allah, as mentioned in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 97. And with regards to the fasting, then the ayah that has been mentioned is Surah Baqarah, ayah number 185. So this is with regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned by starting with Tawheed, and then after Tawheed he mentioned Salah and Zakah. So categorically, when a person starts to learn about Al-Islam, he learns about Al-Tawheed, then he learns about Salah and Zakah and fasting and Al-Hajj. The evidence for this is in Surah Al-Bayyinah, ayah number 5. And the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the pillars, all the ahadith which mention the pillars of Al-Islam in Bukhari, in Muslim, and in the other books of Sunan and the Masanid are in accordance to the ayah of Surah Al-Bayyinah, ayah number 5. Then Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah ta'ala mentions, he says, وَأُصُولُ الْإِيمَانِ سِتَّةٌ أَنْ تُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَبِالْقَدْرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ وَدَلِيلُهُ مَا فِي الصَّحِيحِ مِنْ حَدِيثِ عُمَرَ بْنِ الْخَطَّابِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. So far when Shaykh al-Islam talked about the first pillar, the al-asl al-thani with regards to the religion, he talked about al-Islam. And the connection to Al-Islam, the pillars of Al-Islam are 5. And these 5 pillars are connected to the apparent actions, Al-A'mal al-Zahir. What are they? The outward actions that a Muslim does. So fasting, praying, these are actions that are done outwardly. They are Al-A'mal al-Zahir. Islam is connected, the 5 pillars are connected to those actions, Salah, which is done with the body. Zakah, which is also done with the body. Fasting is also done with the body. Hajj is also done with the body. Shahada, its manifestation is done upon the heart, upon the tongue, and upon the body. So Islam is connected to the apparent actions. And Al-Iman is connected to the inner actions. All the issues of Al-Iman are connected to the actions of the heart. And there are 6 pillars of Iman. And the 6 pillars of Iman are that you believe in Allah, and it is Iman in His existence. You believe that Allah exists, and you believe in His Rububiyyah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Rabb. You believe in His Uluhiyyah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the sole right to be worshipped. And you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has beautiful names and perfect attributes. And we covered this. You also believe in the angels. You have to believe in the angels. His divinely revealed books. All the books which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed before the Quran, the Bible, the Torah, the Suhuf of Ibrahim and Musa, the Injil of Isa alayhi salam. We believe in all these books, the previous scriptures that came before us, but we believe that the Torah and the Injil are corrupted, have been corrupted by the rabbis and the monks and the priests. And we believe in his prophets. We believe in the last day. And we believe in the Qadr. We believe in Al-Qadr, the good of it and bad of it. So we believe that everything has been written by Allah, whether good or bad. If someone from one's family dies, for example, he remembers that the fruit of Iman is taslim, total submission to what Allah decreed. If someone has an accident, lost his job, becomes sick, or is afflicted with cancer or any other disease, it is from Iman to believe that all of this is from Allah's Qadr. It's good and it's bad. And that Allah decreed this for our wisdom. So the Muslim must be content and submit himself to what Allah has decreed and commanded if he truly believes in Al-Qadr. This is based upon the ayah, مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. That everything that good happens to us is from Allah. And everything that bad happens to us is from ourselves, and it is done for a wisdom. It is done with a wisdom, with a hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you want to understand the story, if you want to understand al-hikmah, then read the story of Musa and Khidr alayhi salam. Now when you look, when Musa accompanied Khidr alayhi salam, what happened? The incidents that took place with Musa and Khidr, Musa alayhi salam could not understand the wisdom of why Khidr alayhi salam was doing certain things. But there was a hikmah because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had informed him. So there is a hikmah in which everything is done. The story with regards to the orphans, the stories with regards to the treasure, the story with regards to the boat, and so forth that happened. So everything happens with the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the belief of a Muslim, that a Muslim must believe that everything good and bad is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything that happens, happens for a reason, for a good reason. And everything that happens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had knowledge of it before it happened and had decreed for it to happen, and he would know when it would happen and he would know why it happened, etc. This is what Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah believe in regards to Iman. And a Muslim must know that he is going to be tested. This is why that they asked, a question was once asked to one of the great scholars, Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz, that there are two people that are tried and tested.